Pavelski to the outside, slung it across the net, mouth wide. Waiting as Vlasic pumped it behind. Pavelski tries to escape there. Hacked it back up the boards. Vlasic, a hurried shot. And that one pinballed wide. Can be taken on by Couture. And then it's thrown by Braun and rescued there by Letang. He's able to shuffle one that Braun can grab down. Can't play along, though, as he's harassed on the play by Crosby. Crosby trying to force it along further. Back after it is Hartquist. Played back along to Kunitz. Touched on back to Lovejoy. And a shot is blocked right back to him. Lovejoy yet again popped one in the air. Kunitz settles it down. Meanwhile, the Penguins are making a change. Malkin's unit is out there. Malkin saw this one filtered along now to Ward, taken back by Burns, and Burns, the big defenseman, able to lob it back as far as Mata. Turning right back with it is Brian Rust, shouldered there by Ward, and back deep it goes again for Burns. Led back across to Paul Martin. Martin passes on the money to Carlson, and wide with the shot! Smalling couldn't stop that one. It's taken by Hagelin and a quick change by the Penguins. Carried back ahead by Malkin. Moves up with Hagelin, the trailer. He got it to him. And the shot, a stick save. And then covered by Jones. 4:02 to go. Third period to play. The bumpy ride to the finish. Or maybe not. Wow. 2-1 Penguins. Late third. Responsible for the sixth game being played here. He is responsible for it being a one-goal game. One shot on goal all period for the Sharks, who desperately need to get the game tied, but one single shot is all that has gotten through. Mata settled it down. Kessel flicked it back in. Under 4 minutes to go. Tierney brought it ahead. Braun skates after this one, but offside is called with 3:43 left.
And any time now that the puck is along the boards in the Penguins zone, expect Peter DeBoer's defense to be really aggressive. We heard Keith Jones and Mike Milbury talking about that in the second intermission. San Jose's really not been able to keep pucks alive as much as they would like. But now you're in a territory where you got to take some chances. So when the puck's along the boards, expect their defense to be really active to keep plays alive.
Faceoff win by Crosby. Turned back over, not once but twice, and Hornquist is able to lob it back in. 3.5 to go. It is on Vlasic stick and popped ahead. Letang moves in to keep it going back the other way further. Vlasic turned there by Hornquist. Fed back quickly to Couture. Moves back up along with Thornton and stashes it back in. Around it comes to Letang. Touched it right into Pavelski, and the two of them must go for it again. It's played up to Hornquist, and he filtered it back down. Another obedient change in lines for the Penguins with 3:08 to go. Eventually, if it doesn't change, Martin Jones will be pulled for an extra attacker. Hockey's version of Russian roulette, but that is coming up. Fans are upset because of an icing call against their team. A conversation between Pierre Rassico, the linesman, and Wes McCauley, perhaps over the icing call, but it will stay right there in front of Martin Jones. And now the minute sign gets smaller. It's in the twos. A hand pass stops the clock with 2:55 to go.
For the Penguins, the blue lines become so important. A message coming from the coaches this time of the game. Got to get the puck out at our blue line and get it in at the Sharks' blue line. You don't want any turnovers at that area of the ice.
Malkin wins it. Mata takes it. Lovejoy and ahead. Off of Fair and back down. Jones able to tend it there. Jones saw Burns come by, poke it along now for Vlasic. Rushing along further was Hornquist. Skipped ahead and Letang flipped it. It's knocked down by Burns. Tries to get by, but it was played by a high stick. 2:37 to go here in the third. And still just a single shot on goal for the Sharks here in the third period. They have attempted several. but they've either gone wide or they've been blocked, and that has been a nemesis of theirs, the Penguins shot blocking, not only by forwards but by defensemen. 29 shot blocks tonight by the team in black, gold, and white. The team in teal rushes in. That broken by a walk back out that is turned along by Braun. Punched back in yet again by Donskoy. Chased down by Dumoulin. Pursued by Tierney. Dumoulin there. Jammed one along the pop to Tierney. Then along to Marlin. Reaching in Dumoulin. But it's battled for in the corner. Dragged off by Donskoy. But then sent back up to Cullen. 2:10 to go. Cullen brought it ahead and lobbed it back in. Vlasic will go back to play it. Touched right back along to Donskoy again. We'll keep an eye on Jones as we're down to the two-minute mark here. 2 minutes to go, third period, game six. Brought back ahead by Mata and rolled right back in. Around it, cracked over for Paul Martin, jabbed it on to Couture. Couture starts it ahead with a pass over to Pavelski. He flopped it on, and Couture is able to get in. And then coming to the bench is Jones. The extra attacker is out. It is hit by the high stick of Burns, but the Penguins get it, so there's no whistle. Paul Martin back, harassed there by Haglund. Reverse back up the boards for the turning Ward. Net empty, six attackers. 90 seconds to go. Ward able to bring it ahead, got it on to Thornton. He whipped it in. Letang knocked it down. Letang twisted it along, and it's knocked down again by Burns. Second effort, and it's skipped on now to Vlasic. Hurries it back on to Pavelski. Wheels it right back in again. 1:15 to go. Letang dropped it on. Cut off by Couture. Gotten back to Burns, who kept it in. Vlasic there. Shovels one. Knocked down by Crosby. Sent back out now to Hornquist. Hornquist with the net empty. He scores!
We've talked a lot about shot blocking in this series by the Pittsburgh Penguins. Another shot block by Sidney Crosby. Patience with the puck, makes a play. Hornquist gets the red line, gets the blue line, fires it into the empty net. Still lots of hockey to be played, a minute and two left to go. And the reaction from Mario Lemieux and his wife Natalie. 1:02 left to go here in the third. The Penguins up by two.
Settled down by Murray. Letang fired it around. That one pumped across now and taken by Donskoy. Headed back to the bench again is Jones for the extra man. Donskoy, a shot saved, made by Murray. Rebound is poked away. Back to Braun once more. Around behind, having his stick held was Dumoulin, but he pulled free to battle for this one. Donskoy able to take it away nicely. Rolled it on back now, and it's Couture. Fires, and that one blocked to the corner and can be played on now and thrown along by Haglund and back down. And there will be an icing on this play with 30.2 to go.
There's got to be a timeout coming without question.
Back in December, when Mike Sullivan came here, he told the players from the captain all the way up and through the ranks to the backup goaltender, you guys are professionals. Despite the chaos that we have right now, you just play. During this timeout, you saw those strips that look like strips of tape. And they have written on those a W for each win and a check mark for each playoff series won. They lack a W and a check mark. 30.2 to go. The deficit for the home team is two.
He was the 230th player picked in the 2005 draft. Patrick Hornquist, the man that set him up for that empty net goal, was the first player picked in that very same draft. And they've had instantaneous chemistry ever since Mike Sullivan really put them together and kept them together.
Trying to yell in a couple of goals here. They are standing and waving towels. Nobody telling them to do it. Vlasic across it. Set up. Couture drive went wide. Swept away by Letang. Settled down by Donskoy. Burns unable to get there. Hustling across as Couture's got to play it at center. This comes along now to Haglund with the net empty. And his shot is blocked away by Couture. It's Vlasic to play it. Cleared back down. On goal. Matt Murray has it. And we get a stoppage of play. And a penalty is coming up. A high stick has been signaled by the referee, Wes McCauley.
And Eric Fair is headed to the box. There's the stick on Joe Pavelski.
Those who remain here are standing in support of a team that has caused skepticism in the past, but not this year. Glassing a shot. Knocked down in front, picked up by Crosby, lobbed down the ice. And the Pittsburgh Penguins have won the Stanley Cup. They are mobbing Matt Murray. He keeled over from the attack. The extras that have been a part of the practices come leaping out onto the ice, enjoying all of the celebrating around the net. There are only six members of this team that had ever won the Stanley Cup before. It is so new to the rest. Out of the playoffs on December the 12th. The hottest team in the NHL from around Christmas time to the end, including this. But the chant of the home crowd is for their team. They are proud. The tradition that was first traced by historians to 1904, before the NHL even existed, the ceremonial handshakes. The Sharks wait patiently, hoping that they would be the ones with smiles this time. Not so, but for the first time they reached the final. Normally, it is the captain who leads the line. That would be Sidney Crosby. Again, the Sharks are waiting, and Crosby moves his way to center. And the first to greet him will be the captain of the Sharks, Joe Pavelski. And we'll just watch. Evgeny Malkin, another of the marquee names, and his ex-teammate Paul Martin there. How hard they battle, and what a contrast how quickly it can melt. Despite the disappointment, there is this tradition that you honor.
There was an uphill battle for the San Jose Sharks pretty much all series long. The Penguins, the better the team for the majority of the series. Martin Jones gave them an opportunity, Doc, to get here for a game six. But the Penguins just much quicker. And the team that found a way. And for the second straight Stanley Cup for the Pittsburgh Penguins. And there's Phil Kessel coming over. And that big trade in the offseason with the Toronto Maple Leafs. Not being the guy, being one of the guys. And had a tremendous end of the regular season and a tremendous playoff. But for the second time, Doc, the Pittsburgh Penguins change coaches during the season, as they did in 09 with Dan Bylsma. They win the Stanley Cup. Mike Sullivan takes over this year.
Both goalies were impressive. He pointed out the dominance that Martin Jones had because he just had to face so much more. The coaches work their way through the line and they are last. We will have the presentation of the Conn Smythe Trophy momentarily. Named for the longtime coach, GM, and president of the Maple Leafs. That's why there's a prominent leaf on it. 44 different players have received it, including five from the losing side. The Sharks salute their fans as they depart. Sidney Crosby with Pierre Maguire.
Thank you very much, Doc. You're on the top of the National Hockey League mountain. What's the view like?
It's nice. Wasn't easy getting here, you know, especially, you know, the way things started out. First half wasn't easy, and I think everyone just stuck together, kept going, and, you know, found some momentum there in March and just, continue to keep it going.
Talk about those trials and tribulations, Sidney, because it was not easy for this group. In December, you were not even a playoff team.
Yeah, I think we all felt like we had better as a group and individually as well. And like I said, we just stuck together. We tried to keep fighting and, you know, slowly kind of turn things around as the second half came.
Can you speak about the influence that Mike Sullivan's had on this group as you've gotten along?
Yeah, I think he just held everyone accountable, giving different guys different opportunities, different roles. And, you know, it's up to guys to do something with it, too. And you see some of the young guys have come in and the role that they played for us. But everybody, I mean, everyone has a part in this. And, you know, it feels really good to win your last game of the season.
Can you talk about Matt Murray being the goaltender and your buddy Marc-Andre Fleury not playing and how hard that was for Marc-Andre?
Yeah, I'm sure it's not easy. And, you know, he does such a great job of just being a really good teammate and everything you'd expect from Flower. I mean, that's just the way he is. But I think, you know, all three goalies, you know, Zakhoff, Murr, Flower, they just stuck together. You know, they knew that, whoever was in there was doing a good job. And if it, you know, kept that way, that means we were winning. So they handled it really well.
Congratulations, Sidney. Have a great summer.
Okay, thanks. Appreciate it.
Doc.
The episodes in life that last so many years in memory are often measured in fleeting minutes as they happen. We've been less than 10 minutes from the final horn, but these moments these guys will remember for a lifetime. And especially when they get to hold the Stanley Cup for their brief moment before handing it off. Steve Summers wrote those words, talking about a team that was 12 for 12, 1988 in Hershey, Pennsylvania. We remember them now. And now the announcement of the Conn Smythe.
To the ice for the presentation of the Conn Smythe Trophy to the most valuable player of the 2016 Stanley Cup playoffs.
There's no doubting the passion of hockey fans. This is as loud a building as I've ever heard. How about congratulating the Penguins and the Sharks on a great Stanley Cup final, and your Sharks on a terrific season. The winner of the Conn Smythe Trophy. He has two Hart MVPs. He's now won his second Stanley Cup. It's the captain, Sidney Crosby.
It was Evgeny Malkin in 2009. It is his running mate and captain Sidney Crosby in 2016. It's a handsome trophy. But the one that draws all the attention and is the reason for all this battling and the Penguins blocking 33 shots tonight, allowing only two shots in the third period, is the Stanley Cup. Keepers of the Cup since 1994 will be leading
it
out.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Stanley Cup.
Sullivan, the team played incredibly since you took over. It's the captain's honor to hoist the Stanley Cup. Sidney Crosby, come on back.
A picture, and it's his.